This is an Angela Kane sew-along, sewing for beginners and for the more experienced seamstress. Part 3, the final episode. Check the link if you missed part 1. Visit my site for information on downloading this pattern, along with information on fabrics I'm using here, plus stockists and fabric prices. We completed the centre back vent in part 2. Knowing how to sew this style of vent is a fantastic asset. Add a tailored look to your skirts and dresses, jackets and coats with this technique. It's looking good. And it looks equally good from the inside. The next job is sewing the side seams in the main garment and the lining. You can either machine from the underarm point to the hem of the main garment and then do the same with the lining, or machine all in one go from hem to hem, up the lining and down the main garment to the hem, matching at the underarm and all the notches along the side seams. Stop your stitching about 3 inches from the hemline so that you can deal with the hem later. Pin, baste and stitch, and then press the seams open. I have removed the tailor's tacks and the temporary basting from the pockets. Now for the hem. I am going to do the simplest method for the hem. It involves some hand finishing. Try the garment on, check the length, and tidy up this raw edge if it is uneven. The lining should be a half an inch or 1.5 centimetres shorter than the main garment. Machine the lining hem first. Press a half inch or 1.5 centimetre fold first. Then pin up a 1 inch or 2.5 centimetre hem, baste and machine, and then press. The lining hem is now stitched and pressed. This garment will have a 1.5 inch or 4 centimetre wide hem. Trim away surplus seam allowance on all panel seams to reduce bulk. It is usual but not essential to neaten the garment edge with overlocking or a zigzag stitch. Pin up and follow your machine's instructions for a blind hem. Follow the link for examples in my previous videos. The facing will fold back on itself and will be hand-stitched in place when the hem is sewn and pressed. Then catch stitch this short length of raw edge. Slip stitch along here and slip stitch the lining back in place. Finish the other side in the same way and do the same with the vents. The hem is stitched and the hand finishing is complete. My hand sewing is not the most perfect, but this corduroy fabric is easy to work on. There are many methods of neatening hems, facings and linings used in industry, but I think of this as the dressmaker's method and it will always produce good results. And now for the buttonholes. I have decided on 5 buttons but the pattern is adaptable. You may want to consider pressing a revers here and having fewer buttons. You want to avoid a button at the waistline if you plan to wear this garment belted. Try the garment on with and without a belt. So, decide on your arrangement and measure placement. The buttons will be sewn on the centre front line of the left side and the buttonholes on the right side. You need to start the buttonholes just past the centre line towards the front edge. Follow your machine's instructions for buttonholes. Please practice buttonholes several times on spare fabric folded and with interfacing to replicate your garment edge. Practice cutting them as well. Use a stitch ripper to make a hole in the middle and then carefully snip to the ends with sharp pointed scissors. If buttonholes frighten you, then use bold press studs instead. You can have dummy buttons on the outside. The garment will then be finished. You will find this a very useful addition to your wardrobe. Worn with a polar neck sweater and knitted tights, it will carry you through to the spring. Make it up in linens and lightweight wools and wear it sleeveless when the weather is warmer. See the links below for my other sew-along videos. Sew jeans, sew the roll collar coat, sew t-shirts, sew the classic silk shirt, sew swimwear, and many more start to finish sewing videos. If you haven't done so already, please subscribe to this channel, Angela Kane Sewing TV, to be kept up to date with new videos and patterns. This pattern is from my site, angelakane.com. It is available in 9 sizes, UK 6 to 22. Join for all patterns or buy as a one-off download. Thank you very much for watching this sew-along series.